students, coming to the next topic, that is the software myths. So what is a myth? Actually, myth is nothing but it is a belief, whether it is wrong or misinformation or anything. So a myth, we call it as, means wrong belief or misinformation. Then what about the software myth? So why we are considering a myth in a software? What is a software myth? So software myth or beliefs, those are also beliefs about software. So the myths about software and the process used to build it. So here the software myths are the, it's just a beliefs about the software that we are using and the process used to build it, build the software. So in those areas, our beliefs will be there in the view of different people, in the customer view, in the management view, in the user view, the development view. So though every person is having their own software myths, means their own beliefs about the product or the process and about the software. So that is about the soft, the, that you call it as a software myth. So the myths have number of attributes that causes serious problems to the softwares, that causes serious problem on software. So actually there are three types of myths will be present. Totally there are three types of myths. One is management myth, customer myth, and the third one is developer or practitioner myth. So these are the three different types of myths. Now let us see one by one. So what is first, let me explain about the customer myth. What is the customer myth? What is the belief that the customer will always think about the software or the process? Actually, the software myth here in customer view, the software myth believed by customer who can be internal or external. Who can be internal or external. So what the main the customer will think about, what is his belief about the software? So what the customer myths about the softwares, about the process they are used to build. So the customer believes, customer believe that general statements of objectives is sufficient to begin writing a program. So whatever the general statements that are present up to so far now, those are enough to write a program, he may believe. So that is only the belief, okay, that you call it as a myth, the customer myth. In the customer point of view, point of there, so customer believe that general statement of objectives is sufficient to begin writing the program. So to write the program, some small sufficient statements are enough, he may think, he believe, and the requirement changes are easy to accommodate because the software is flexible. He think that changing requirements is sufficient. Change requirements, always changing the requirements is easy. The software is, so the customer is thinking that, he is believing that changing the requirements is always easy because software is a flexible. He may think that the software is a flexible. It is a belief. It is a wrong belief. Okay. You can say it is a wrong belief about the product, about the customer, developers, about the company they are giving the project. Okay. Changing requirements is easy because software is flexible. And another myth, he is thinking that this is everything, this is primarily seen in evident because the client always think that software development is an easy process. The main thing is the customer always think that the customer or a client always think that software development is an easy process. Actually, the person who is going to be implemented, he knows the pain of creating the product, he creating the code, creating the software. But the cust in the view of the customer myth, they are these are all the beliefs of the customer while they are giving the project to the company or any organization. So this is a customer myth. Now let us see what is the management myth. What do you call this management myth? Okay, so let me explain about the management myth. So management myth means here we have some standard and procedures for building the management people. What they believe that some standards and procedures were for building software is enough, so developers have everything they need to know. Okay, they thought that some standard tools are present and they think they are sufficient for developers to develop the program. Means they are belief, the management belief is whatever it presents so far here in the company, those are enough to develop a project. But what we can say internally, the developers may need some extra tools to develop a project. Okay, but the management believes those are enough. If we are behind schedule, we can, the another management myth is they can think that if you are behind schedule, we can add more programs to catch up. So they thought that we can add more programs. Okay, more programs to catch up. It's just they believe, the management belief. And they think that we have state of art software development tools after we buy the latest component. They think that they will always buying the latest component computers. So it is sufficient. They think that there is a management myth. They think they have latest computers. Actually, usually the myth of manager was think always a good manager can manage any project. A good manager can manage any project. So this is about the management myth. The management belief. Okay. So the software myths are divided into three types: the customer myth, management myth, and the developer myth. Now coming to the third one, that is the developer myths, or you can call it as a practitioner myth. Practitioner myth. It is a developer myth or a practitioner myth. So what the developer believes, what he think about the software. So the developer, they think if I miss something now, I can fix later. His negligence, because whenever he is writing the code, he know that he is missed something. Okay, even though I miss something, I can fix it later, because if any no error will come, it will be solved. If error will come, then we will think about that. Means they believe that okay, we can fix it later. That is, so they think that if I miss something now, I can fix it later. Once the program is written and running, my job is done. So he think that okay, once I written the code, okay, today's my work is over. If it is running, the code is running, okay, my job is done. Means he's just believe that he's not fully dedicated, means he's just doing his work. He thought that whatever he done is correct. until a program is running, there's no way of assessing its quality. So this is also his belief. And next, the only deliverable, for a software project is a working program. The main thing he will think is, whatever the program that software I going to be delivered, that should be in working. So it's just beliefs. So these are all the three different types of software myths. One is the customer myths, management myths, and the developer myths. Means in those way views, what they think about the software, what they think about the company, the customer, what they think about the software, what he think about the management and the developers, and the management myth. So what he thinks about the company and what he thinks about the project, what his beliefs, and in the view of the developers, so what he believes about the project. That's it. Thank you.